As we come out of Purim, I wanted to share a message related to Purim, but really related to all year round, and particularly this life moment that we find ourselves in. At the end of the Megillah, the Jewish people accept upon themselves the holiday of Purim and the mitzvot associated with celebrating Purim. The pasuk states, "Kimu v'kiblu ha'yehudim." The Jewish people established and accepted upon themselves to commemorate this day of Purim. And this idea of kimu v'kiblu, that they accepted upon themselves, they established this day, becomes almost a rallying cry. It becomes a reassertion of Jewish values, of Jewish holidays. The Gemara in Shabbat discusses how the Jewish people at Har Sinai, in the moment of Mount Sinai, when they received the Torah, it was received with difficulty. It was received in an almost a sense of coercion. They had to receive the Torah at that moment. But kimu v'kiblu, the Jewish people in the diaspora, the Jewish people in Shushan, after their victories, after they've established themselves in the moment of the story, now they accept this holiday with a renewed vigor, with a sense of power, that they can create new holidays, that they can commemorate this existential moment they were in and celebrate being saved from them. And one of the things I was thinking about is it's so interesting that Matan Torah, the reception of the Torah, is really not celebrated or commemorated in the Torah. It's true, later Chazal identify Matan Torah, the day where the Jewish people receive the Torah, it gets identified with the holiday of Shavuot and becomes associated, and that manifests itself today in how we stay up all night learning Torah on Shavuot. But the Torah itself, it doesn't describe the energy of the people. What did they decide to do after they received the Torah? The one thing we know about is the Egel, which was perhaps a misfire, but and perhaps a place where they sent their energies in the wrong direction. But what's so clear from that story is that there's a certain type of energy that can be felt when something new has come about, when there's an acceptance or a recognition that we are in a new moment. And I feel this is true for Purim, where we talk about Kimu v'Kiblu, but it's also true today. It feels for me, and I know for so many of us, that we're in a new moment. We're in a new moment with coming out of what feels like two straight years of COVID. Of course, there were ups and downs, but it feels like there's really some kind of light that we're experiencing. And I think what we learn from the Purim story is that that has to be noted and commemorated and recognized, both the existential crisis and fear associated with the time of being in a darkness, but also really seeing how exciting and how wonderful it is to see so many people coming back to the Beit Knesset to hopefully celebrating Purim parties today or yesterday, depending on when you watch this video. Recognizing both the fear, the difficulty, and also the celebration of this moment of acceptance, of renewing our commitments to our community, to our friendships, to our families, beyond the Dalet Amot, beyond the small containers that so many of us have lived in, as we open up and extend back into a broader community. Let us kiyem v'kibel, let us kimu v'kiblu kol hayudim, let us accept upon ourselves, re-accept upon ourselves, the responsibilities that we have as a Jewish people. Shabbat Shalom.